My primary focus, and I don't even have a topic this morning, so I'm going to just call it Psalms 142, which is where we're going. Psalms 142, amen. Psalms 142. Then we'll briefly go to 1 Samuel, the 22nd chapter.
Soul. I cried unto the Lord, O Lord, I I said, thou art my refuge and my portion in the land of the living. Attend, God, unto my cry. For I am brought very low. Deliver me from my persecutors, for they are stronger than I. Bring my soul out of prison, that I may praise thy name. The righteous shall compass me about, for thou shalt deal bountifully with me.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, Jesus. Just lift your hands up all over the sanctuary just briefly. Just say hallelujah to the Lord. Hallelujah, Jesus. Set my soul out of prison. Hallelujah, Jesus. That I may come forth and praise thy great name. Hallelujah, Jesus. In the midst of the congregation, in the midst of the assembly, in the midst of the righteous. Hallelujah, Jesus. May I praise the matchless, the uncountable name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah, Jesus. Set me free today, God. Release me, God. Command the prison doors to be opened, God. My soul needs release. Hallelujah, Jesus. My soul needs a jubilee. Hallelujah, Jesus. I need freedom. I need victory. Hallelujah, Jesus. For all the enemies that compass my soul, God. Today is my freedom day. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Today is the freedom day. Hallelujah, Jesus. And every prisoner ought to declare, I'm free in Jesus Christ. Hallelujah, Jesus. I'm free in Jesus Christ. Hallelujah, Jesus. God, we bless your name, Jesus, for freedom in the name Jesus Christ. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. We bless your name, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. All this week, as I was before the Lord asking the Lord what to say, he brought back several passages of scripture, but the primary area of focus was Psalms 142. Now, understand here, this is also personal for me because this message actually books in a message that I preached in September 28th of 1998. So let me explain the relevance and the significance to you why this message is so dear to me and what the Lord has been saying to me. Back in September 28th of 1998, for many of you don't know, I was then the assistant pastor of Haven Arrest Sanctuary of Praise. And for about a week, I had had a recurring dream. And in this dream was a man that was in prison. This man had been in a prison that had been turned into a prison. And when I saw him, he had a long matted beard, dirty clothes that were torn and worn. And at the time, he had no hope within his heart or in his spirit or within his soul to be released from the place that he was in. He had given up hope. In the morning that I went into church, I was going in to preach the message, and that night before, God told me to preach it in rags and with a filthy face, and at the time I had hair, messed my hair up, and I had to preach it in chains. And all that week I kept looking for chains, and late that Saturday night I drove up to my house, not realizing what was going on, and there was a chain hanging on the side of my house, and God told me to take it off and put it on and wear it. So I wore that way during the time that I preached that message, and when I got to church that morning to preach, I couldn't even get myself together. I cried the entire time. until I got up and I went into the pastor's office and she asked me what was wrong, and before she could even allow me to get the answer out, she closed the door and said, I know what this is. So when I got up to preach the message, before I had a chance to even start praying, the Holy Spirit took over in my prayer. But the thing that I'm trying to declare to you this morning, there are some of us that are here that are in a cave in our spirit, man. And the state of our hearts and our minds, although we think that we are free, we are not free. We are bound. We are locked up. We are chained. We are incarcerated. We are in prison. We think that we are free. And we think that the circumstances of life have given us freedom. But we really aren't free. But in this case, not only are we locked up in a cave, but we are pursuing, we are being pursued by someone that knows our destiny in life. Hallelujah, Jesus, that is seeking to destroy us and to kill us and annihilate us before we have an opportunity to stand up. We've been anointed once, but before we get to that next level of anointing, there is a spirit that is pursuing us, that is hot on our track. And some of us, although we are in prison, but at the same time we have been released from the prison, but don't fully understand, we may be free from the four walls that have incarcerated us, but we're not free men from the circumstances that have caused us to be incarcerated. But we're still yet bound, hallelujah, Jesus, by those that are pursuing us. And our soulish man, hallelujah, Jesus, is crying out from the inside of us, God, release me and set me free, God. Hallelujah, Jesus. Some of us are toiled with the pains of life. Hallelujah, Jesus. Some of us don't understand the circumstances for which these chains have been formed and have been created around us. Hallelujah, Jesus. So let me declare to you what the chain made, each and every link of the chain. Hallelujah, Jesus. Some of us, the chains were formed not because of things that we've done, but because of things that were done to us. Hallelujah, Jesus. And there's some chains, links in the chains that we had a part in. Hallelujah, Jesus. Let me tell you, one of the links of the chain that is incest, when someone came in and raped you and took things that belonged to you. Hallelujah. Someone killed your self-esteem, as well as your dreams, that added another link to the chains. Some of us were physically and mentally abused, that added another link to the chain. Some of us as young men and young boys were raped of our dignity and our soul, our sexuality, and some of those things have served to bind us, but God wants us to be free. But some of those things that we have been set free from, let me declare and tell you right now, they are in hot pursuit of you to overtake you, to overcome you, and reacquaint you with what that thing used to be in your life. Hallelujah, Jesus. But God doesn't want us to make its reacquaintance. What God wants us to do is declare to him, I may be a prisoner now, but today is my day of what? Freedom. Hallelujah, Jesus. So let me get to Psalms 142. Psalms 142 is a psalm of David when he was in trouble. You can read 1 Samuel 22 when you get home. I'm not going to go there because I got a lot to cover in a very short span of time. And verse 1, he cried, he says, I cried unto the Lord with my voice. My voice unto the Lord did I make my supplication. Now understand this, that this psalm, if you see in your Bible, some of us have subnotes where it says, Muscal shout of David, a prayer when he was in the cave. Muscal means instruction, or it's an instructory psalm, that is psalm with a lesson of wisdom and of hope behind it. It is to give you understanding, and it's also to be presented in a way that is skillful. That's why Ephesians 5 and 19 says, speaking to one another in psalms and in hymns and spiritual songs, singing and making melody in your heart unto the Lord, because he wants it to be so catchy that you hold on to the words of the song and the melody of the song, that even if you don't recall every word, at least you understand the gist of what the song was talking about. So in a time of duress, you would remember it. It was an original song sung by David. And David understands here that he was in a place where he had to cry. In other words, if your soul wants to be released from prison, you have to do what? Open up your mouth and make it known unto the Lord. You have to make it known by the crying of your own voice, by the sound that God is looking for. And those of us that have been in deliverance ministry knows that when a person is about to be delivered, there is a certain sound that comes out from out of that person's spirit and out of their being. Just because you cry, just because you make your voice loud, doesn't mean that you're ready to be delivered or healed. Hallelujah, Jesus. It's just a noise that you're making. Hallelujah, Jesus. But there is a certain sound that breaches the earthly realm and transcends into the heavenly realm, that gets God's attention, that wakes him up, that causes him to stand up from his throne and say, now I must come down to see about my children. Hallelujah, Jesus. So God is not looking for just a noise from you. He's looking for the noise of deliverance. Hallelujah, Jesus. Somebody say the sound of deliverance. Hallelujah, Jesus. So it goes on to say, when he made the sound with his own voice, he took ownership of it. And he said, the Lord did I make my supplication and my complaint. In other words, I want you to hear my complaint. What is trouble? What is on my mind? In other words, God, you must understand that I want my supplication. I'm going to make my supplication known to you. In other words, I'm going to direct my voice to you for mercy. I want you to take me into consideration. Hallelujah, Jesus. You may be hearing the prayers of everybody else, but God, look out for me. Consider me. And I'm going to submit to you. When you're in the throes of being delivered, you have to become selfish in your spirit. It is me, God. It is me, oh God, standing in the need of prayer. It's not about your brother or your sister at that time, although you want to see them saved, but your soul. Hallelujah, Jesus, is in danger. Your soul is in trouble and it needs to be set free. Hallelujah, Jesus. Then he goes down to verse 2 and he says, he poured out his spirit. He poured out his soul. He poured it out just like blood was being poured out to the altar. I know Apostle talked about the blood last week, and then she talked about the blood being poured out on the altar. But God showed me one different. He